Hello, my Scorpios. I thank you so much for joining me here today. And yes, we are here with another Life of the Zodiac video. Today, of course, we're talking about the life of Scorpio male. All right. So keep in mind, all that is stated may or may not resonate with every Scorpio. So you just take what applies to you and chunk the rest. All right. So guys, yes, I'm going to be looking at my notes because this Mercury retrograde has somewhat affected my memory and my speech, so I just want to make sure I get my message out to you as best as possible. Okay, so let's get started. So the life of the Scorpio male is usually he's born at a time during, you know, hardship, or there's something serious going on. Perhaps both parents are working. You know, there's a lot going on. And because of this, your parents or maybe your guardian has somewhat overlooked you. Now, granted, most Scorpios come from rather or medium-sized to large families. And because of that, well, you kind of like get overlooked as far as, you know, receiving affection and attention and just overall nurturing in general, at least the necessary amount that a typical Scorpio needs, okay? And because of this, well, you may have the tendency to do everything in your little powers to get some attention, to get some sort of, you know, notoriety, whatever it is, you find a way to do that. And through that comes misbehaving or just rebelling slightly, just enough just to be able to get some sort of recognition from your parents. Now, you're not really ever close to either one of your parents, so it's sort of like, okay, I go to mom for this, I go to dad for that. So you really don't have, usually don't have a favorite parent that you sort of cling to for anything. Maybe your dad for more advice, because mom could be a little, you know, closed off at times and serious nature. Nevertheless, you're the child in the family that feels somewhat shunned. And not just by your parents, it could be through other adults, teachers, you know, your peers. They may treat you in such a way that you feel like, you know, a little cut off from the world, like you were, you know, the red-headed stepchild, okay? And because of that, you may take on this persona of one that is, you know, a little rebel, or you might bully your fellow classmates or, you know, the children in the neighborhood verbally, you know, psychologically, whatever. You may just sort of deflect whatever it is that you're feeling as a child. And it's not because you're a bad kid, it's because, well, you feel deprived in a way. And so, needless to say that your overall childhood is what molds you into who you eventually become as an adult. So, this period in your life is going to have a great impact on the way you view the world. A significant impact. And as you grow older and become a little more responsible, a little detached, a little mysterious or enigmatic, and even weird to some, you may take on like little hobbies that no one really quite understands, or maybe to yourself, become a loner, a bit reserved and removed from just, you know, the overall day-to-day, you know, life of what a child typically engages in, and just may be seen as just different. And that again is another, you know, shot at you, and you don't really know how to handle it or feel about it. So you sort of just continuously just do your own thing, and you learn that sort of works for you, being this loner, mysterious being. And by the time you're like 10, you're already at the peak of puberty. And you've learned so much just from doing things alone and being in your own world and just kind of like sticking to what it is that you know, even though you may at times hang out with your cousins or your brothers, whatever, and get into boyish, you know, shenanigans. Nevertheless, you still always come back to yourself, and it's because you are sort of in tune with your sensitive side. And many water signs are clairvoyant and have some sort of ability to be able to see and feel certain things. And when you may disclose some things to people, they may not quite believe you. And then that too is one more thing that you're like, oh, no one believes me. I actually saw my dead grandmother the other night in the bedroom. You know, it's like, it's one more thing that just sets you back and just makes you even more different from all the other children. And it's bad enough that you're probably already going through puberty and having these body changes and experiencing things, so you're feeling a little out of norm and out of sorts there as well, and don't really know who to talk to about it. And even when you mention it, it's kind of like dismissed. It's like, okay, well, you're fine, just do this, whatever. There really isn't any attention or instruction that is given during this period in your life, which is very critical because, you know, the Scorpio sexual prowess is like big. And you may begin to have these feelings and may not know what these desires are coming from. And then there may be this good old uncle who teaches you a few things or says things to you and, you know, what it is that you should do. And you actually listen to that. And then that's when, you know, you become a man. So you usually lose your virginity at a very young age, you know, and it's usually to someone who's slightly older than you are, you know, maybe by a couple years or whatever. And because younger girls are probably turned off by you because they feel like you're just so different. So you may attract older type women pretty much all of your life. And it's due to your maturity. Okay? Even when you don't act mature, it's just your outward appearance. You may already have, you know, pubic hairs or whatever. So to that extent. But as you begin to grow as, you know, into a teen and go into those adolescent years, your world shifts. And this is when you feel things the hardest. You know, things still don't make sense and you're trying so hard and struggling to maneuver in this world at a pace that is almost like you're at a standstill. The way you feel in life is almost indescribable. Okay, and so you tend to live in your head. You become this deep thinker, and you may have like one friend that you really cling to who sort of understands you but is completely different from you. Like he may not be anything, or she may not be anything like you, but they somewhat understand you and have this sort of connection, and this is what gets you through. But the flip side to that is, unless your parents or your guardian begin to give you the necessary guidance and teachings that is required of a young man, more so than likely, you may begin to indulge in not just sex, you know, alcohol, a drug of choice, and sort of like go hard with it. As most Scorpio males do, there's like one thing, if not multiple things, that you really are into and you go hard. Now, mind you, your grades in school, though you may be highly intelligent, you may just purposely not care or may not be engaged because you have all of these outside negative influences allowing you to just digress, you know, to fall back on what's most important. And it's because at this point in your life, you see the world is just so flawed and unfair. And you may take on this, you know, pessimistic view of the world. And even with your experience with women, this is when that little player mentality comes about. You know, you may prey on the little, I won't say prey, but you may, let's just say it. You may prey on the more innocent or airheaded type females because they're a little more easy and sort of like makes that a game. So you learn how to play mind games and manipulate even the school system. You begin to learn how to do just shady little, just shicey things and sort of get away with it, you know, but that's the rubble within. You know, you want to stay on a lighter side and listen to that inner voice that tells you to do good, but society just keeps coming at you. It's like, you know, you're the outcast of the community. And because of that, you rebel. All right. Nevertheless, you usually get through school some kind of way. Either you play, you know, some sort of sport. And because you play, you're an athlete, you know, there's the cheerleaders or the girls that keeps you motivated to go on. And then just right after school, it's like your world just sort of becomes one big giant mystery. There really isn't a plan usually. You sort of like just go with the flow. And between the ages of like 20 and 25 is when you encounter so many different things. Like you may actually be in college or have multiple jobs, and there's always like a lot of things going on in your life, so much so that no one else can really keep up. It's like you usually have a lot of things going on, good and bad, and you're like a mixed bag of just a lot in excess. Everything with you is usually like in excess. Okay, so you might have drama going on, some sort of shady dealings, and this could be pretty much your entire adult life. You sort of take on this sort of lifestyle because it's befitting, and your greatest challenge is when you actually meet that girl of your dreams, the one who can actually somewhat tame you, okay? Because this is one of the least tameable signs, and there's only one way to get you, you know, by accepting you and showing you love, speaking to you as though you are human with respect, in a way to where this person can feel you on a much deeper level and tap down into the abyss of your heart to what it is you're truly feeling, to what it is you're really thinking, that type of female. More so like an earthy type, okay? This is the one female that can take you there. However, because of all of your past with other females and the drama, it's really hard for you to embrace this sort of situation. You want it. You know this individual may be loyal, and you may cling to this individual and become possessive or even take on selfish nature, if you will. So much so to where she doesn't feel secure in the relationship, and you may have challenges there. Despite all the other craziness you have going on. I mean, yeah, but this is the one type of person that usually sticks with you. And for some reason, you guys sort of like drift apart. And because of that, you may find yourself going from person to person, doing this, moving from state to, you may find yourself doing many different things. Like Scorpio men are the least conformed individual. It's like you move about. Even Gemini is a little bit more stable in their thinking and their ways of doing things. But if you reach a Scorpio man who's a little less immature and unevolved, even when you are evolved, your life is still a mystery to you. You know, you sort of just pace yourself. So by the time you're 30, you've probably already been married, have a few kids, ready to remarry, have a girlfriend on the side, maybe in some sort of corporate world, you usually have a position that allows you to reveal your power, like your inner power. There's something about you that you possess this, I don't know, it's not leadership, but there's something about you that puts you into a field that kind of makes you shine, but not really. It's like you're like the force behind the scene type of position. Yeah, it's kind of really complicated to explain. But again, Scorpios in general are complicated. And I really took in a lot of interest in doing my research, sort of like the Virgo man. This was very interesting. And to just know that your life is one that is just one big giant ball of a lot of things. And I mean, there's some excitement there, but then there's a whole lot of drama, there's shadiness, there's a whole lot to you. And it takes a certain type of individual to be in your life, even your friends. Even as you get older, you may not have a lot of friends, and you still may not be as close to your parents as you could have been. Your siblings, maybe you may still have that bond, that connection, and you may cling on to like aunts and uncles, you know, older aunts and uncles. You find yourself closer to them for whatever reason. You've learned a lot from your aunts and uncles. Okay, but usually in life, your life is just, it is what it is. You know, you just have to be mindful to not be selfish in your relationships, in your business dealings, you know, because you can be overbearing and begrudging and just take life a little too seriously to the point to where you don't give others the chance to prove themselves to you again. You shut down, you close up, become a little vindictive, and you just continuously take on this negative. You feed into that negativity, you know, venturing over to the dark side. But if you can have more control of your desires, you know, that's the Scorpio motto, I desire, because your desires will allow you to be, will cause you to be selfish, and you think about yourself, even though you really are intending to be mindful of your family, you know, your wife or whomever. But that's going to be your biggest feat, is to just sort of put what it is that you want at that moment aside and think about what's really best, you know. And for you cross watchers out there, if you are dating a Scorpio, the best thing that you can do is to just really reveal who you are to him. Let him see all of you. This way it's easier for him to open up and to give you that loyalty and that trust that you deserve, and vice versa. That's the easiest way, because when you begin to hold back and be secretive, well, you get problems out of your Scorpio. Okay? So yeah, that is all for the life of the Scorpio male. It's, it's a bit complex, and there's just a whole lot of mystery to you, and it just takes a lot of tapping into, a lot of energy, a lot of work, but that's only going to be done by one special person, okay? And you'll know who that is. But that is all for now, my loves. I thank you for joining me, and until next time.